In this video, I'm going to show you how we can make a simple chessboard using Python and OpenCV. So let's get started. So first, I'm going to import OpenCV by using cv2 command, and then we're going to import numpy as np. Then shift enter. Now we're gonna make a black image of 100 by 100 by using NumPy. So we'll name it as black np dot zeros. So it will be of shape 100, 100, and data type will be of np.int8. Now similarly, we are gonna define a white block of 10 by 10 pixels. So for that we are gonna use np.once command, and we are gonna make it of 10 by 10, and data type will be of unsigned 8 bit integer. Now we are going to consider the first 10 pixels of the entire black as white. So this is the corner part actually. Now we'll also make sure diagonally opposite part is white. So for that we'll consider the 10 pixels row wise and 10 pixels column wise as white. Now we'll consider the first 20 pixels from up to down and left to right as one entire square, which we will be repeating. So this is a square. Now what we are going to use is, we are going to use a tile function of numpy, which is a very useful function. So chess np is equal to np.tile square. We are going to repeat it 4 by 4. We are going to show it. Now cmap equals to gray function. Gray. This will make sure that the image that we are displaying is of gray color space and not of RGB or VGR. PLT is not defined. Okay. Import mat dot lib dot pyplot as PLT. This is how we got a chess board. Now, what this style function exactly does is, if you consider when we created this first entire black image of 100 by 100, so this is an entire black image of 100 by 100. Then we created a white image of 10 by 10, so this was that 10 by 10 image that we created initially. And what we did was we tried to change this part of the image into white, and then again this part, that is from 10 to 20, that is 10 to 20 from top to bottom and 10 to 20 from left to right. So this part and this part, we turned it into white, and this was the opposite, diagonally opposite part, that is this one. Then what we did is we named this part 0 to 20 from here to 0 to 20 from here as the square part, that is this part. Then we repeated this part 4 times vertically, 4 times horizontally, and then it will automatically cover the entire part. Now to make this look more clean, we are going to use plt.xticks. Similarly, plt.yticks. So now we have got rid of the axis marks. If you don't want this to appear, all you need is to put a simple semicolon, and then you won't even have that as well. So this completes the tutorial. Hope you find this tutorial useful. Thank you very much.